conservative blogger. Kirsten Powers, the USA Today columnist and former Clinton administration official. Andre Bauer, former lieutenant governor of South Carolina and a Donald Trump supporter. And Bakari Sellers, former South Carolina state rep and a Hillary Clinton supporter. Mary Catherine Hamm, we are going to start with you. I would like you to finish this sentence for me.
You love these.
For Donald Trump, tonight will be...
An attempt to marshal all of the late-breaking scandals about Hillary and some of this confirming narrative information from WikiLeaks. I think he has a lot of opportunities here. Some people have said, "Oh, is he gonna punch low?" He may, but he has a lot of opportunity to actually take some real issues and go at her with them. The WikiLeaks reveals a lot of stuff that voters already believe about her. There's this late-breaking FBI quid pro quo thing that was in the FBI documents that he should marshal. The question is whether he can do that, and it's always been that when he does, it's a little clumsy. If he can land some punches, not a bad idea.
Kirsten, you have not heard this one before. Finish this sentence for Hillary Clinton. Tonight will be...
Well, can I just say, for Trump, it'll be his last chance to turn things around.
And you finished the sentence I gave you.
I know. And for Hillary Clinton, I think this is her chance. It's her chance to put it away. And she basically, right now, has Trump on his heels. She's consistently ahead in pretty much every poll that is at, and significantly out, and significantly ahead in a way that at this late date, it's very hard for Donald Trump to turn it around. So she basically can put it away tonight, I think, if she just... really kind of obviously doesn't take the bait from him, which she's been very good, I think, at sort of staying above the fray, but also making a positive case and using this as an opportunity to talk about sort of her vision for the country and to give people a positive case and a reason to pull the lever for her, not just to vote against Donald Trump.
Andre Bauer, Donald Trump supporter. You know, as I said, you do support Donald Trump. You've also been willing to give some tough love in the past. You've watched him do two debates now. What would you like to see him do differently tonight?
Well, number one, I'd like for him to be more upbeat. I'd like for his look to be a little happier when he's not on camera, when they've had the double screen. I want him to be cheerful. I want people to be excited about coming out to vote for him. You see, people here are passionate. He's got to get that passion there. He's got to hope to keep her base down and not energize them to come out. And his base has got to come out in big numbers. And if he continues to talk about the economy, protecting the borders, not being the world peacekeeper anymore, and how he can really change the total environment in Washington, that's what excites his base, and that's what excites people in the middle that are sick of the status quo.
You have liked Hillary Clinton's performances in the past two debates. What is there something you would like to see her do differently? If you had to pick something, what would it be?
Well, I'm not the only one who liked her debates. I think scientific polls show that she won both the first and second debate, and I think she gave us two different styles. I think, to be completely honest, I don't expect Hillary Clinton to do anything differently in this debate. Hillary Clinton, right now, where she's sitting in the polls, has a better chance to win Arizona and Texas, then Donald Trump has to win.
So you're just saying
Virginia,
coast is
Virginia.
Not good debate advice.
No, we're not saying coast, but I want her to be Floyd Mayweather. You know, she's the champion going in. She's going to play a little defense. It's going to look pretty at times, but she's going to be bobbing.
Bakari, Dan Ball is one of my favorite writers for the Washington Post. He sort of suggests that Hillary Clinton may have a higher bar tonight than she's had before. He says, one, she's got to deal with emails. Leave that aside for a second. But the second thing Dan says is that she's got to make an affirmative case, without using the word Donald Trump, about why she should be president of the United States.
I think she has been doing that, and I would love to hear that on tonight's debate stage. I think everybody's sitting up here. You know, if we just disarm ourselves of any partisanship, we want these candidates to tell us why they should be the president of the United States and what a Hillary Clinton or a Donald Trump presidency shall be. But if we're talking about strictly winning and losing, what does Hillary Clinton have to do different or have to do better? Absolutely nothing. I mean, Hillary Clinton needs to come out and be the better debater, which she is. I mean, Donald Trump is the kid who scores baskets in his own goal.
That's one mental image.
Mixed sports metaphors, but we'll go with it.
We're going to go with it. Mary Catherine, Jeff Zeleny, his reporting this morning is that Hillary Clinton's having to prepare in a different way than she has in the past. Prepare for her own words. Prepare to talk about the words of her aides, WikiLeaks, emails. She's got a lot that has come out in these WikiLeaks emails that she hasn't had to deal with before. You're not in the business of giving advice to Hillary Clinton, but... what do you do about it?
Well, I think the upside is that she has prepared very well in the past for the things she's done in the past, and she's done them fairly well in the first two debates. So if she can file that away and then add on this other stuff, it is a challenge. But I wonder, look, Chris Wallace will know the facts of this stuff cold. So that's who she needs to worry about. I'm not sure that Trump will know them as cold as Chris does. So she'll have to worry about both of them to some degree, but the moderator more. I think she can probably defend, at least, you know, conversantly enough to get past most of these things, and Trump won't be landing a bunch of punches. But what Picari points out, or what Picari's talking about, and I'll throw in another sports metaphor, a prevent defense doesn't always
You just won John Berman's
heart
right now.
The only thing it prevents is winning.
You just won him over.
Believe me. Only thing worse is the four corners. That's a different sport altogether. Kirsten, one of the things that's new about this debate versus the last debate, we had Access Hollywood. We had that tape that came out. Donald Trump had to respond to that. Since that time, since the second debate, we've had these women come forward, one after the other, making a broad range of accusations here.
Right.
How should Donald Trump, or what does he need to do to address that tonight?
I honestly don't think there's anything he can do to address it, because, first of all, his position has been don't believe anything that anybody says unless they're saying it about Bill Clinton. And, you know, he has claimed that there are no witnesses, and now that witnesses have come forward, I think he will continue to claim that none of this happened.
Do you think he'll be as combative as he has been the last week?
I don't know why he would stop being combative. I mean, I'm not sure. We've all been waiting for this person to show up and act presidential, and it hasn't happened in the first two debates, so I don't know why it would happen tonight. I think for Hillary Clinton, on the other hand, she doesn't want to go there with him, because then he will come back at her with the attacks on her husband, and that just isn't a place that she wants to really be, I think, spending her time in the debate.
Andre, the New York Times is reporting that Trump is preparing to bring up Hillary Clinton's health. This is not uncommon for him to bring up in rallies, not uncommon for him to bring up in interviews, or they've even cut a TV ad about it, but he hasn't brought up her health issues in a debate setting before. Do you like that idea?
I don't. I think there's too many other points to score on the WikiLeaks, on where he takes the vision of the country, how bad the system's broken in Washington, even with his own party, and how he's really fighting the entire system. And if you want substantive change, you're going to need that. I don't think the health issue moves a lot of voters.
Picari, they're trying to wrap me, so I'm going to get in trouble, so you have to be quick on the answer. The James O'Keefe video here, which shows Democratic activists, Democrat operatives, talking about maybe inciting violence at Trump rallies. Hillary Clinton, does she need to separate herself and disavow that tonight on this stage?
If the question's asked, of course you disavow yourself from any violence, any inciting of violence that goes on in any rallies. I mean, that's just what you do. Hillary Clinton tonight, beating on that point, is going to be very presidential. That is what separates the two candidates. One has the temperament, one is presidential, the other is Donald Trump.
Seems a moving definition of what is presidential these days.
Thank you.
Guys, great to see you. Last minute negotiations between the campaigns and the debate commission, all about the very top of the show before the debate even begins. What is going on here? The Clinton campaign is joining us next.
And then what is the one thing that Donald Trump can say on that stage tonight to change the trajectory of the race? We will ask one of the world's most decorated Republican debate coaches coming up.